Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to FIRA Day 3. And it's a great to kick off this demo pitch with a look at Saft. Saft have a century of experience in batteries, of course, and they want to talk to us about some of the latest technology they have as you look at how we can go to electrification and to new batteries. So let me hand over right now to Xavier Iricabal, who's online, who's a product manager for Saft. Over to you.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this FIRA pitch. My name is Xavier Assabal. I'm working in Saft in Bordeaux plant, so not far from your location. And I will present you different technologies about chemistries and battery system for vehicle. Let me share my presentation. Okay, let's start. I will start with a few words about Saft. So, who is Saft? So Saft belongs to Total Energy since 2016. We are 100% owned by Total Energies. And Saft is made of five divisions. So five divisions. We have the mobility division, grouping aviation, rail, and off-road, where I belong. ESS, making large battery for renewable energies. Industrial standby, connected energy and space and defense for specialty batteries. A bit more about off-road segment where I belong. We are dealing with construction, agriculture, mining batteries, as well as material handling or GSE and bus and truck. All these markets of the industrial vehicle are addressed by my segment. And besides these five divisions, Saft has also two joint ventures, one pretty famous recently, which is ACC, which is named Automotive Cell Company, which is the joint venture between Saft Total Energy, Stellantis Group, which is Peugeot, Citroën, Fiat, Chrysler, and a newcomer recently, Mercedes-Benz. So the joint venture is 33% owned by the three companies. And is dedicated of manufacturing lithium-ion cell for automotive markets. So they are in the scope of passenger car and less than 3.5 ton vehicle. They will manufacture cell in Nersac in a pilot plant, and then after in a gigawatt hour factory, whether in Douvrin or in Germany. I will explain you just after. They focus on NMC chemistry. And the second joint venture is Tianneng Saft Energy in China. So Tianneng, a large scale manufacturer of lead acid battery, which also dealing with lithium ion technologies, where we focus here on LFP batteries and of mass market for e-bike and also other electric vehicles. The footprint where we are. So we are two locations in France where the development are done. So in Bordeaux, we have the research, we have also the development in Bordeaux, and we have a manufacturing of nickel cadmium batteries for rail and aviation. The factory for mobility basically is mainly Saft Nersac, where we manufacture cylindrical cell and where we manufacture and assemble batteries for the off-road mobility. The second factory, which is important for us, is Saft Jacksonville, which is located in the US and which is manufacturing prismatic cell like this one here. Then the other factory in the off-road mobility, we have one factory in Czech Republic assembling battery and one factory in China who is today assembling rail and aviation battery, but could be used for also a mobility battery. And besides this, the two joint venture location will be for ACC Bordeaux for their R&D center, will be Nersac for their pilot line where they will experiment, test, and develop new processes, and then 2 gigawatt-hour factory, Douvrin in France, Kaiserslautern in Germany, where there will be also a R&D center. And then Shangxin for Tianneng Saft Energy, where they have both R&D cell factory and battery factory assembly line. So now let's talk about lithium battery technology. So I will first explain the chemistry and then our vision for battery system. So lithium cell technology, an overview. In SAT, we are dealing with chemistries for 100 years. We are a 100-year-old company. And today in lithium ion, we are dealing with three main chemistries, which is NCA, NMC, and LFP for the cathode. And for the anode, we are using whether graphite or LTU for high-power cell. These are the main trend chemistry we are using, but we are also using very exotic chemistry in lithium ion, in space and defense, for example. But these are the ones we produce the more in our Jacksonville factory and in NASDAQ factory. So this, I would say, three main chemistry, NMC, LFP, LTU, has disadvantage, pro and cons. So we can see on the chart that if you need high energy density, then NMC is the best chemistry because it has the higher voltage and the higher propension to accept more energy in a cell. Then we have LFP, which is also energy chemistry, which has the benefit to have cheaper material inside, so it's more economic, but you have the drawback to have less energy for the same type of cell. And then you have LTO, which is pretty different application where the power is really needed. And then you have the maximized power and a very long life, about 10 times the other chemistry in terms of cyclability. These are the chemistry we are working. And then in terms of format, we are dealing with cylindrical, historical SAF standard. We are dealing with prismatic formats. I can show you a small cell here, which is a PHEV2 format, and we are dealing with prismatic pouch cell also in the US. In terms of application of the chemistry to industrial vehicle, I put in five categories, from small to large vehicle, and then technology like hybrid, hydrogen vehicle, or automotive vehicle. In this line, basically, I will highlight which chemistry is better in which case. If we are talking about very small and compact vehicle, then you need to have a maximized autonomy. And this kind of vehicle, NMC chemistry is really adapted because you can fit a lot of energy in very small environment. Now, if you have a bit more space and you are less constrained, then you can use LFP for larger vehicle because it's more economic and it will bring a good TCO, which is close or even better than lead acid battery. Now, for very large vehicle, it clearly depends on the space you have, on the chargeability you need to select the chemistry. So if you want to charge very fast, so very fast is less than 1 hour. We have tech chemistry today that can charge in 10C rate, so it's about 6 minutes. But in battery system, we use more 5C rate, so charging in 15 minutes. Then you can have power LTO cell or power LFP cell as well. But power LTO cell is really adapted for massive operation like 24 hours a day and so on. And on same vehicle, if you want to have more energy, but you want to charge at night, for example, and you have time to charge, then energy LFP chemistry or energy NMC chemistry is very well adapted. Same difference between LFP and NMC. It's a matter of size and space you have on your machine. Then when it comes to hybrid vehicle or hydrogen vehicle, you have the diesel engine, you have maybe a fuel cell in your vehicle, and you want to have a battery used as a buffer between the power requested by the machine and the diesel engine. So in that case, power cell, like power LTO or power LFP, are pretty much adapted to this kind of application. Why two chemistry here is clearly the life. If you want autonomous vehicle, or you have a very, very harsh operation, then LTO will give you a very long life. If you are operating time to time, then LFP will have enough cyclability for 10 years, with charging one time a day or having, I would say, medium profile in hybrid. Then, if you want to maximize your autonomous vehicle, which is the case here in the FIA, where we have a lot of robots, if you want to make them work all day long and you want to charge them very fast, then LTO is clearly the solution. You will have a 10-year lifetime by charging 4-5 times a day. So now, how the market is split in terms of technology, clearly the size of the vehicle will tell you which voltage you will use. So from very small machine, like you can start at 12 volt, 24 volt for a pallet truck, you can grow up until 48 volts, 96 volts when it comes to a machine, I would say less than 5 ton, between 3 ton and 5 ton max, we are at the limit of this voltage, and above 5 ton, you enter in a range where normally you would need a power between 400 volt and over. 400 volt is clearly the voltage of automotive, so there is a mix there, but what we see in large industrial vehicle, the voltage is more likely 650 volt. This is the typical voltage you see in bus and truck, and you find the same powertrain in large vehicle. So it is, I would say, a more or less standard voltage level. And then in terms of energy content, well, in this case, it will really depend on your usage. If you are using a lot of the vehicle, you will need more energy and so on. So what I can say is that small vehicles are between 10 and 30 kilowatt hour, and we can go up to 800 kilowatt hour for very large machine and very long autonomy. To give you an estimation, a bus is between 200 and 400 kilowatt hour. What we see most common is 250 kilowatt hour for 1 day autonomy. The target is for electric vehicle is not to last several days. The target is to have one full day of operation, you charge at night, and then the next day you repeat. Today, chemistry have enough life cycability to last 5 to 10 years without any problem. SAFT approach in this market is basically we really consider the off-road and the industrial completely separated and high volume market like automotive, and we decided to go to a solution that could adapt to most of vehicle, because off-road market is very, very different type of vehicle. And you can see at the FIA, all the machines are very different in terms of usage, in terms of size. And then it makes a market which with very, very different requirements. So to answer this market with, I would say, the affordable batteries, because developing a battery is very long and qualifying a battery is very expensive, we came up with a modular battery solutions. For the low voltage system, our vision basically is to afford a 48 volt battery, which is similar to this one. And the 48 volt battery has 4 kilowatt hour, and you can put two in series to make 96 volt powertrain compatible. This modular battery, you can also extend in parallel, so you can achieve 50 kilowatt hour at 48 volt or 100 kilowatt hour at 96 volt, which is really enough for small and medium machine. We have integrated all the BMS inside, the protection like contactor, fuse in the battery, and all the pack are all the same. So if you have a problem, you replace one pack within the machine and then put a new one, and you can continue the operation. What we wanted to put as a high performance is battery is charging. We are charging in 1 hour. We don't want to charge in 2 hours, 3 hours. The idea is for some application, the customer want to charge the battery midday during the lunch time, and 1 hour is a requirement. Now our vision for High voltage, we want to offer also the modularity in the voltage range, because as you saw before, you have machine 96, but you have 400, some 650, And we want to give a flexible solution. So we propose the same concept of battery, but with a different architecture. In this kind of product, you don't have the electronics and the protection inside the battery, but in a dedicated power box. So in the power box, you will find all the protection for your pack. And you add as many modules as you want to come up with your voltage. And a high power version also could be studied if you need to charge very fast your batteries. So I'm at the end of my presentation. I'm ready to hear your question if we have a bit of time. So do not hesitate to ask questions.
Thanks, Xavier. Are there any questions in the audience here? I think you've given a very comprehensive explanation of what SAF can do and about your new lithium batteries. And so I'm sure that if there are any questions, they can come to you online for that. But since there are no questions, I think you've obviously done a very comprehensive job. So thank you very much for talking to us online today. And of course,
you're welcome.
And of course, if they do want to chat, they'll get in touch with you shortly, I'm sure.
Yeah, don't hesitate to come back to me. It was pretty short. I compacted the presentation, so there's a lot to say about lithium-ion batteries and application. So we are open and we stay close to you to hear you in this FIRA show. Thank you very much to all, and have a nice show.